Your next topic is baseline measurement. The measurement of baseline forms the most important part of a triangulation operation. Okay, means the measurement of baseline, nothing but setting of a baseline, is a very important part in triangulation system. Now, the baseline is laid down with great accuracy of measurement and alignment, as it forms the basis for the computation of triangulation system. Why we need to discuss about baseline measurement? Because, as I told you people earlier, it is one of the very important part. Baseline setting up is very important part. Now, next question comes to your mind is, are we going to set or are we going to lay the baseline? Means we need to lay the baseline with great accuracy of measurement, and also alignment should be proper. Alignment means what? Your line of sight should be proper. Okay. Then now this forms the basis for computation of a triangulation system. Okay, if I want to compute the triangulation system by this triangulation system, means this is the first basic point. Okay, setting of the baseline with proper measurement and proper accuracy is needed. Now the second point is, the length of baseline depend upon the grade of triangulation. Okay, what is the length you are choosing for the baseline? It depend upon what? Normally depend upon the grade of triangle. For the first order triangulation, you go for a larger length compared to second order and third order. That is what they told. Apart from the baseline, several other check lines are also measured at some suitable intervals. Means, while setting up the baseline, what happens? If I want to get the accuracy, means at certain distances, some check lines. Okay, if I want to check the accuracy of that baseline length, we're going to set up some check lines. Okay. At some intervals which is near to that particular baseline only. That what they are told in the third point. After knowing about baseline measurement concept, your next topic is selection of baseline station. Okay, now they are written here, selection of site for selection, make a correction, that is selection of baseline station. Now, since the accuracy in measurement of a baseline depend upon the site condition, means I've selected some site, means I need to set up some baseline in this particular site. Means the accuracy of that baseline depend upon what? The site conditions. Okay, therefore, it need to consider some points before selecting a baseline station or a site for the where you're going to set up a baseline. We need to consider some following points. Okay, that one, the first point is, the site should be fairly level. If, however, the ground is slopy, the slope should be uniform and gentle. Undulating ground shall be avoided as far as much as possible. Now in this point, what they are trying to tell here is, we are going to select a station in such a way that, if this is my site, okay, where I am going to place some baseline station. Now your site should be like this. Okay, what happens? Either it should be smooth or level. Okay, this is the condition. But we doesn't get, at some areas, we doesn't get the smooth or a level ground. Then what we need to do, even the ground is slopy, that slope must be gentle like this one. Okay, it should not be like this, a steep slope. Okay, you need to select a site where the slope is gentle. Okay, like this you need to take. Next one, and also they told something, that is, undulating ground shall be avoided. Now what do you mean by undulating ground? Like this. The ground must not be an undulating one. Either you need to go for a flat one, even the slopey, it should be gentle like this. Okay, not for the steep one and also not for the undulating ground. That what they told in the first point. Now in the second point, the site should be free from obstructions through the whole of the length. Okay, now what they told, even it is having obstruction, means the clearing of that ground should be economical, means the labor cost, all those things must be minimum. That is what they told in the second point. Now what happens here, I selected some site here, I want to place some baseline. Now what happens, initially the ground may be like this. It is having some obstructions, maybe some trees are there, or maybe some extra ground is present here, or extra clay soil particles are present here. Means then what happens, you should have to select a site in such a way that where it should not have any obstructions like this. Okay, first one, if it is not possible, I have obtained some site where some obstructions are there. We need to select a site in such a way that where the cost for clearing all these obstructions is minimum. Okay, like this you need to choose. That what they told in the second point. Now in the third point, they told the extremities of the base should be intervisible at the ground level. Means this is my baseline where I set up in this particular station. Means the extremities, this point is the extremity, these two points are the extremities or the end points for this baseline. Means now what happens, if I am seeing from this level ground, means both these end points must be visible. Like this, you need to go for a selection of the baseline station. The fourth point is the ground should be reasonably firm and also it should be smooth. And water gaps, if they are present, should be closed, nothing but fume closed, if possible, not wider than the length of the long wire or tape. Okay, what is first condition you need to look after? The site where the water gap should not be there. Water gaps should not be there. Okay, even if you find out the site where some water gaps are there, that length or that width should not be more than the length of the tape what we are using. Next one, the last point is that site should site extension to primary triangulation. This is an important factor since the error in extension is likely to exceed the error in measurement. Okay, now this point is very, they told in a very technical way. Now what they told in the last point is your site, SIGHT, means your view, what you are doing, your view, okay, of your view of survey should be such that you need to look for a site extension. Means while setting a baseline station, you need to set a baseline station for the primary triangulation system. You need to see it as if you are carrying out a primary triangulation system. Then only what happens, you set up a larger length of a baseline. Then what happens in the future? In the future, if I want to extend that line, means it becomes easy. That what they told. Okay, why it becomes easy and also it will be helpful? How? Because while you are extending the line, what happens? There may be error due to measurements. Okay, therefore, for minimizing that, at primary level only or at the initial level only, you need to make such a way that your site or your view should be done for the site extension in a